Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Amen. I know that there is a big repentance going on in this nation. God has spoken with me about the historic, the grand mega historic revival meeting that's coming up to Kisumu. And in that very, very mighty conversation, the Lord Jehovah, he took me again to that meeting and showed me a very, very big meeting. It is going to be historic in its nature and kind. I see millions and millions and millions of people gathered at one place to worship Jesus, to worship Jehovah, and to worship the Holy Spirit. There is a big revival that has exploded out in the church, and now it's absolutely obvious to everybody. And then the Lord showed me the level of healing that will take place in Kisumu. Now, the level of healing that will take place in Kisumu is almost tenfold what you have seen in Eldoret 1 and Eldoret 2. So there is going to be a big, humongous visitation of the grace of God. The tremendous glory of the blood of Jesus is going to flow for the entire meeting in Kisumu, and there are several levels. So this now becomes the third level that the Lord has shown me. So the first level that I told you will be at the peripheries of the meeting, and all the people that will not be able to enter the meeting will partake of a very, very shocking healing anointing that will consume the peripheries of the meeting. And then I've seen now a higher level, a second level, that will consume from the periphery towards the entire inside of the meeting, and it will be very great, it will be very shocking. People will tremble when they see this. Some of the creative miracles the Lord will do for those who have no limbs, those who have no eyes, those many things the Lord will do. I've seen many, many, many crippled babies that will get up and walk, the crippled boys and girls, the crippled men, the crippled women, the crippled old people. Many wheelchairs will be abandoned at that meeting. And then I've seen the many, many, many blind babies, blind normal children, normal age children who are blind, girls and boys, blind men and women, blind old people. And then I have also seen the many, many deaf and mute who are babies, who are mature children, boys and girls in schools, the deaf and mute who are adults, who are mature also, aged. So it's uncountable numbers of deaf and mute. And the lamb, the Lord will stretch their legs. He will literally touch their legs with his own hands. I've seen the Lord touch their legs and pull their legs, stretch them and place them on the ground and strengthen them, extend some of the columns of their legs, extend some of their limbs, their hands, and strengthen the necks, and put skulls where there was no skull, where there was a rotting head. Many, many of these conditions. I've seen also the bleeding diseases stopped, the mentally ill are restored, and the many wounds that dry up. I've seen a lot of other healings, leukemia, the blood conditions, leukemia, diabetes, hypertension, the liver conditions, the renal conditions, all these people doing dialysis. The Lord is coming to restore internal organs, the spleen, the heart, the stomach, the esophagus, the tongue, the nose. He's coming to heal those wounds that are inside, the internal bleeding, those ulcers, the necrotic tissue that have covered different organs, the small little tumors that have surrounded different livers. The Lord is coming to do major, tremendous, historic work in Kisumu. I've also seen the Lord coming to do other healing that have not happened before. The people with hydrocephalus heads will be reduced, Down syndromes. So this becomes a very important time in the history of the church, because even HIV/AIDS, that has for a long time defeated human conventional medicine to find a cure for it, he's coming to overrule the physical laws of nature and to heal them and turn them negative. And at the same time, the tumors will dissolve, the fibers will be dissolved. Let everybody come into Kisumu. Let them come expecting a major historic healing that will turn their lives all around and catapult them and throw them right into heaven. It will give them an everlasting testimony that will cause nothing again to ever drift their hearts away from Jesus. And so I have seen, then after those two levels of healing, then the Lord now shows me yesterday and today a major, major, major historic level. So this is going to be almost tenfold what I have seen in Eldoret 1 and 2 coming to Kisumu. And you are very much aware that Kisumu is the pad, is the place at which the cloud of God that I prophesied came and entered the church through. That's where the cloud landed. And now the Lord is sending this restoration and revival of the latter glory across to the ends of the earth. And so this, again, we do not know. This becomes one yet another meeting whose height and limits we cannot tell. Anything can happen from Kisumu. Anything might happen there. Anything will happen there. The Lord will do mighty, mighty, mighty things that will stand this land. Sometimes I even fear that the Lord can do things that he has not done before. The cloud, you know, anything can happen in Kisumu at this hour because of the proximity with which we have drawn towards the coming of the Messiah. Now, everything I've spoken until now is God's tremendous unspoken, unseen love. The love of the grace of our Lord Jesus that is now beginning to manifest, to reveal itself to the church. The past people had not known what really the grace of God that was realized and experienced at the cross at Calvary, what it is of what or what it will look like in these last days. But now we are beginning to see the unraveling. We're beginning to see the revelation of the glory of the grace that was realized and experienced at the Calvary cross. So there was so much more after the cleaning of sin and setting man free. So there was so much more in the healing and the physical restoration of the church. Apart from the spiritual restoration, then he's saying the physical restoration of the church in order to separate out the church, that the church may now be known as the people whose God is Jehovah. The people whose God is Yahweh, that they may now be this separated people, the elect, the holy elect of the Lord. And all these things are happening in a very short time, and at this time in the history of the church, because the Lord is exploiting them to speak to the inner chambers of your hearts, to let all the nations of the earth and the peoples of the earth know that this is the hour to draw closer to the Lord. For the Lord, he is good. This is the hour to draw closer to him. And as he heals us, then now you turn away from your sins. You observe a much more holier life. It is a very blessed time because this is again the time at which all the nations are going to observe a sacred assembly. And we have received a lot of confirmation of pastors and gospel leaders of the gospel from all over the earth who are coming to converge in Kisumu. They are coming to witness for themselves what the Lord is doing in the church, especially in this land, that they may develop a deeper hunger, a hunger that cannot be explained in this life, and be able to fetch this fire and take their nation. We have got pastors from the UK coming, a lot of pastors from the Netherlands coming, pastors from Trinidad and Tobago, pastors coming from Angola, pastors coming from Brazil, pastors coming from Uganda, pastors from all over the world, Germany. All nations are coming from Finland. They are coming to witness this mighty visitation of this hour, the visitation that many generations simply read about. And they imagined in their minds how that visitation the Bible inscribes would look like. But now here comes a generation, a beloved generation, that has been afforded the wonderful, indescribable privilege of partaking, of being the beholders of this visitation of this hour. How precious would this hour be? And that's why I'm saying that we need to be very careful. Sometimes judgment and revival enter at the same time into the house. I think this is the moment of awakening when the people of this nation, and of course globally, need to understand that whenever the Lord in the Bible allowed a given generation to partake of his visitation, then unto that generation a responsibility was bestowed. Which means there are certain benchmarks of God that they would now have to live by. And that's why there is this very tremendous conversation about Jehovah coming to visit the church. And he has chosen that the place of that visitation is going to be in Kisumu, the city of Kisumu in the nation of Kenya, the land of revival. Again, when the Lord loved Israel many times and blessed them with his visitation and positioned and stationed his towers from that nation of Israel, then it meant that from that day on, Israel would be living in the sight of God, in the eyes of Jehovah. And that is the responsibility that I am talking about today. But how to say that all these tremendous visitations are coming and there is going to be an unspeakable healing, diabetes, the leukemia, cancers will dry up, all of them, the tumors will dissolve, and the cripples will get up and walk. Many wheelchairs will be abandoned at the wheelchair, at the altar and outside the peripheries of the meeting. Many crutches and hips will be left there. He's saying many blind eyes will see, many cane, the white cane of the blind will be abandoned there, like you say in Eldred. But he's saying higher, almost tenfold what you have seen in Eldred 1 and 2 combined. And he's talking about people with wounds, people that had spinal cord crushed, like Phoebe that we know of, Phoebe Muhoni, that came to Eldred, of Kitale, that came to Eldred when the spinal cord was crushed, when the back injury was too big. Even she could not get up. She was relieving herself forever. She was lying. She could not even sit. Now, the Lord is saying that when you saw that and you thought that that was a climax, that Phoebe is today walking and running, he is coming to do that tenfold in Kisumu. So all the people of Kisumu, the poor people of Kisumu and the neighboring areas of Nyanza, Kisii, wherever, Western, that were not able to afford the fare to go to hospital or to come to Eldoret for the healing service of the Lord, now the opportunity has availed for them to move a short distance and get right into the center of the visitation of Jehovah, their God. The Bible speaks very clearly that during these times when the glory of God is walking with the church now needs to be more careful. The priesthood, the pastors need to be more diligent in the way they minister before the Lord, because now they are ministering in the complete presence of Jehovah, the God of Israel, our Creator. Again, the blessed tidings that I bring to you from the throne of God this evening is that I have seen an unspeakable level. I've seen a level of healing. The healing anointing of the Lord that is going to come to Kisumu will be very shocking. And some of you may think that that is it now. The Messiah is here now. Nobody knows the day or the hour. But blessed are you that will be able to translate this visitation into the holy preparations for the glorious coming of Messiah, my Lord and my King, the King of Zion. Shalom.